Hello YouTube, Mikey Cal here, and this is video number 20 in my series on utilizing Blender as a video editor. Now, in the previous video, I showed you guys how you can zoom your movie in, and you can use pan and scan to make sure that the subject of the movie is kept in the view. And in today's video, I'm going to show you guys how to do the Ken Burns effect. Now, for those of you that don't know who Ken Burns is, he's a famous documentarian. He did a documentary called The Civil War, and what he does is he'll take an old photograph and he'll zoom in to a component of that photograph and then move around the photograph and tell a story. And this is really easy to do with Blender. So let's just get right to that. So let's go to the Add menu, and we're going to import an image. And I have one right here. Now the proportions are all off, so I need to right click on the image strip and go to the properties, and I need to put a check mark in the image offset box. And there you go. Now, we're going to be doing some keyframe inserting. So what I need to do is bring up our dope sheet and graph editor. And we're going to do that by going up to this little triangular area up here and holding the mouse cursor over it until we get this crosshair. Left click and pull to the left. And we're going to go to this drop down here, and we're going to select dope sheet. And we're going to get this drop down here and select graph editor. And we're going to hold our mouse over, or the mouse cursor over the dope sheet and hit our home button to zoom out, and hold our mouse cursor over the graph and hit the home button to zoom out. There we go. Now let's right click on the right handle of the image strip, hit the G button, and let's pull it out to about 26 seconds. You can see the time down here. Now we're going to need to add a transform layer, so let's go to the Add menu and go to Effect Strip and select Transform. And I always tell you guys, whenever you make a transform layer, right click on the original strip, go to Strip menu, and mute that strip. There you go. Now let's right click on our transform strip. Let's go over to the properties on the right, and we're going to need to insert keyframes for our position and for our scale. So first, let's actually put a check mark in the uniform scale box. And we want to center this photo, so let's left click on the X coordinates and pull to the right and place it somewhere around the middle. And let's zoom in because I want to fill the entire frame. So let's left click on scale and pull. And let's make some adjustments to the position now. Let's try to get everybody in the picture frame. So I need to zoom out a little bit, so I'm going to click this little left arrow next to the scale. Let's keep clicking it and make our subtle adjustments. Okay, that will do. This is the starting point. This is where our movie is going to begin. And we're going to keep this view for about 5 seconds. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually left click at 5 second mark right here and place the green line. And you can use your arrow keys to actually move it left and right each frame. And what I'm going to do is we're going to insert our keyframes into our position and our scale. So hold your mouse cursor over the X value and hit the I button. It turns yellow. That means it inserted a keyframe. And you can see the keyframe up here, and it's also on the graph. Let's do that for each of these. Let's see, Y, let's hit the I button, hold it over scale, hit the I button. And now you can see they've named each of the keyframes here, and they've color-coded them. And what we want to do now is, this is the starting point of our transition, our first transition. So let's go ahead another 5 seconds to 10 seconds right here. And I'm going to adjust this with my arrow key to the left. There we go. And where do I want this transition to end? Well, let's place it at the ending point by going up to the X value and the Y value and changing them to the appropriate position and the scale as well. So actually, let's start with the scale by left-clicking on the scale, and it'll zoom in. We're going to zoom in to my grandparents who are sitting in the center. So I'm just going to click this little left arrow next to scale. Okay, that will do. And what we're going to do is we're going to hold our mouse cursor over each of these properties and hit I. So hold it over the X, hit I, hold it over the Y, hit I, hold it over to scale, hit I, and you can see each of the keyframes appearing on the graph and in the dope sheet. Let's hold our mouse cursor over the dope sheet, hit the home button to zoom out so we can see the keyframes better, and do the exact same thing over the graph. Hold the cursor over here and hit the home button, and we can see the curves here. So let's actually click this back, this jump button that actually jumps us back one keyframe, and hit play and see what this transition looks like. There we go. So basically, at 10 seconds, we have finished our first transition. So let's actually click the this jump back button again, back to our last keyframe, and let's do another transition. Now let's actually make it so that it actually stays in position for 5 seconds. So what we're going to do now is we're going to jump ahead to 15 seconds, and we're going to go to X value over here and hit insert keyframe, and Y, insert keyframe, hit your I button, and scale I. Now what this does is it's actually going to make sure that it stays in one position for a total of 5 seconds. So let's actually go over our dope sheet and hit our home button. Let's see what we have. Now, do you notice that we have this solid line between these two keyframes? That's the dope sheet's way of showing us that there is no change in property values from this keyframe to this keyframe. So it's an easy way to see where we have our stops. And we're going to have a 5 second stop where it's just going to stay at this position before it moves to the next one. Okay, so let's also hold our mouse over here and hit the home button again to see all the curves over here. You can see it's all straight across. There's no curve between this keyframe and this keyframe. So now what we want to do is we want to move to another subject of this photo. So let's jump ahead another 5 seconds to 20 seconds. And let's place it on somebody else. How about the ladies here? So it will now move to here. And all we're going to do is we're going to insert keyframes, I. And we didn't change the scale, so we technically don't have to put I, but I'll put one there anyway. Okay, so let's zoom out. We keep zooming out and hit the home button here. And you can see on the scale, it didn't change. So it's showing us that there's a yellow bar there. So that's a nice way of seeing that we didn't change our scale, but we did change our Y value and X value. Perfect. And let's hold our cursor over here, hit the home button, and we can see the rest of the curves. And now what I want to do is I want to actually go back a couple keyframes, and we're going to play this out and see what it looks like. I'll play it from the beginning, in fact. We'll go all the way back to the beginning and hit play, and we'll see it stays for 5 seconds. At 5 seconds, it should start doing a transition right now. It's zooming in. At 10 seconds, it will stop. It will stop for 5 seconds. And once we get to the 15-second mark, it will continue to move to my grandmother on the left
and great aunt on the right.
And there you go. So that's how you do that. And a couple other things I want to show you guys. You can actually deactivate a transition by actually clicking on these little volume controls. I don't know why they make them volume controls, but they're really an on-off switch. If you click here, it will actually deactivate this value from changing. It'll actually deactivate the keyframe. So if I actually go back, and I'll actually deactivate all of these, and we'll actually watch what happens when I play it from the beginning. So it doesn't do anything. It doesn't know to change anything. It just stays where it was. So that's a way that you can actually just deactivate one of the keyframes or a number of keyframes. And I think that is all you guys really need to know for doing the actual transition process for a photo to do the Ken Burns effect. So I'll see you guys in the next video.